Today, I'm embarking on a slightly late intercity service from the Algarve to Lisbon, and I'm excited to have you join me on this adventure, where I'll show you the train and give details about this route and service. Come along! Olá e bem-vindos a Loulé! Hi and welcome to Loulé, the nearest station to Vila Moura, a well-known vacation spot and to many other interesting places in the Algarve, Portugal mainland's southernmost region. It's a quaint small station where time seems to have stopped in the 19th century. Evidence of this can be found in the separate small building housing the toilets, reminiscent of facilities from 100 years ago. To my surprise, my train passes in the opposite direction to Faro, with a delay of around 1 hour, when it should have already been heading to Lisbon with my train. The beginning of this trip doesn't seem very promising. With little else to do, I spend some time train spotting. Lucky as I am, this class 450 shows up, operating a stopping service to Lagos. At last, at 6:50 PM, almost half an hour late, my train arrives. I find it interesting to note that it is entirely made up of modernized Sorefame cars, with not a single co-rail in the consist. I had anticipated traveling in one and comparing them to the Moroccan co-rails, which were featured in a recent video. Maybe next time. As time is of the essence, I board the car in front of me and then walk to my seat, taking the opportunity to briefly show you the bar and the first class section. Here there's this alarm, related to some sort of malfunction in the interior doors. The conductor will solve the problem in a while, but for now, this is what it is. Fortunately, there aren't any passengers in this area. And finally, my seat. Car 11, seat 102. It's already well past time for today's trip map. There are 334 kilometers from Loulé to Lisboa-Oriente, which will take 3 hours and 31 minutes, with several stops including Albufeira, Tunas, Grândola, Pinhal Novo and Entrecampos. Our first stop is Albufeira, another well-known vacation village. There aren't many passengers here as well. It's a brief stop, and with a delay of around 30 minutes, we continue our journey. The train is quite empty, so I'm going to take a tour of its amenities and share a bit about the history of these cars. They were built in 1968 by Sorefame and used all over the country for many years. In the early 1990s, CP, which had been using co-rail cars for about half a decade, decided to upgrade 45 of these older cars to co-rail standards for use in the intercity service. They were modernized in-house, giving them the fresh look that they still have today. The interiors were modified and the bogies were changed, increasing their maximum speed from 140 km per hour to 200 km per hour. Fast forward to today, these cars are showing their age. There are rumors about an upcoming interior modernization process. However, they don't need a lengthy or complicated overhaul. Repairing damaged parts, adding new padding to the seats, and stalling power and USB outlets in every seat, and maybe some onboard entertainment, is all that these cars need to bring them up to 21st century intercity service standards. What do you think? Do you like these cars? Do you have any ideas to modernize them? Let me know in the comments below. After this next stop, I'll offer a seat tour. For now, our stop in Tunis, a junction in the Algarve. Passengers to and from the western part of the region connect here with the trains from and to Lisbon. Class 450s, like the one we saw in Loulé, operate the stopping services to destinations such as Silves, Portimão and Lagos. Originally these seats were quite comfortable, but now they are somewhat worn out. However, this is an easy fix, with new padding and upholstery, which can bring them back to life and their former glory. Continuing our journey to Lisbon, we stop at several stations, many of them seemingly in the middle of nowhere. I end up having a coffee at the train's cafeteria. There's no scenery today as it's pitch black outside. After already more than 2 hours and a half into the trip, we reach Pinhal Novo, our first stop in the Lisbon region. As can be easily observed, the windows are so dirty that it's difficult to see outside. Even during the day, visibility is reduced, and at night, it becomes extremely challenging. Not far from Lisbon, I want to share how much this trip costs. A first-class ticket from Loulé to Lisbon, bought on the day before traveling, costs €29.10. I feel that this price may be a little bit high considering what is offered. Tickets are easy to buy either on CP's website or through the app. I recommend buying them on the website because there, unlike on the app, you can choose seats with power outlets. For some reason, these seats aren't marked on the app. At 10:19 PM, with a 23-minute delay, we finally arrive at Lisboa-Oriente, my final destination. On the track next 2 hours, the intercity service to Porto ensures the connection for passengers heading further north. Finally, I would like to share my thoughts about this trip. CP sells tickets promising to transport passengers from point A to point B, and that's exactly what it does. However, in this day and age, and in a long-distance service like this, railway operators need to put in a little more effort to attract passengers. In many ways, this intercity service seems neglected. The worn-out seats, dirty cars and delays lead me to the conclusion that CP isn't taking care of the intercity service and brand as well as it should. On the plus side, the interiors are beautiful and with a little care, they can be restored to their former glory. Will I use this service again? Maybe, but I won't go out of my way to travel in CP's intercity service. Have you traveled on this service recently? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. As I walk to the head of the train, I want to thank you for coming along on this journey. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel and leave me a comment below. Your support is very helpful and, indeed, means a lot. Thank you for being here and see you next week!